So hey everyone, today we'll be performing an experiment on mode characteristics of a reflex klystron. To perform this experiment, we'll be in need of a klystron power supply, a klystron tube with a mount, isolator, cavity meter, detector mount, and which is connected to the CRO. Fine. To perform this experiment, we have to start the klystron power supply. So there is a standard procedure to be followed. So before turning on the klystron power supply, make sure that the beam voltage knob, that is this, should be set to minimum, and the regular voltage knob should be maximum. After these considerations, turn on your klystron power supply and change the switch from off to on. So you can see the beam voltage is at the 193 volts. So set the beam voltage to 215 or 260. So I have set my beam voltage to 260. So using this knob, select it to current and wait for the current to raise up to 12 or 13 milliamps. So you can see our current got raised to 12 milliamps. So after this, change to rippler and see that rippler is at maximum, that is minus 275 volts. So you can see the output on the CRO, a stable square wave is formed. Fine. To perform this experiment, we will be changing the rippler voltage. We will be decreasing the rippler voltage in terms of 5, and we'll be note downing the corresponding peak to peak voltage on the CRO. Fine. So the first reading goes as 270. Decrease the rippler voltage using this knob and keep it to 270. It's nearly 270, and note down the value, the peak to peak value on the CRO, which is given by 556 millivolts. So change it to 265, decrease the voltage in steps of 5. So you'll be getting a table of all the values of rippler voltage corresponding to its peak to peak value on the CRO. So 265 is still 556 millivolts. Go on decreasing this, now it's 260 millivolts. For 260 millivolts, we have a value of 552 millivolts. So keep on doing this until the rippler reaches to 150 millivolts. So so the reflex klystron has three modes. So as you can see, this is the first mode of operation. We have a stable square wave. As I keep on decreasing, the stable square wave on the CRO got decreases. So this was our first mode, and if I further decrease the rippler voltage, you can see we have got a square wave on the CRO again, which is the second mode of operation of our reflex klystron. If I further decrease this, the wave on the CRO got vanished, and if I further decrease this, we have the another we've got again the square wave on the CRO, which is third mode of operation of the reflex klystron. So we have three modes of operation of reflex klystron. So decrease the value of rippler in steps of 5 and note down the corresponding peak to peak values on the CRO. So this was the experiment. Thank you.